from the individual messages that I get from the Peaceabilities Facebook page, from the Viber groups, and even emails sent to us. Yan yung common na question. Okay pa ba mag-invest sa mutual funds? Kayo, anong tingin nyo? Are you investing in mutual funds?
Yes, I have. As per your advice, yeah. I'm actually with Philequity.
Philequity, okay. Raf, have you tried? Have you tried investing in mutual funds?
I have never tried, actually.
Never tried, okay. Sige. Konti lang to, hindi to 7,866 slides. 28 slides na mabilisan lang talaga. Because you would need about 3 to 4 hours just to get into the introduction of mutual funds. And kaya, alam ni, practical world, you millennials watching now, tinimingan ko naman, mga right dun sa schedule na gusto ni Raf, matatapos natin to. I want to get into the types of investments muna before I get into mutual funds para ma-appreciate na kagad yung papasok tayo sa discussion of mutual funds. First off, there are basically 2 types of investments. Fixed income type or lend type of investments, tsaka yung equity type or buy type of investments. Ano ang malaking pinagkaiba? Yung isa, may promised na benefit. Tawag doon sa promised benefit sa fixed income or lend type interest. Doon sa isa, walang pinapangako na benefit. Merong benefit, pero hindi interest ang tawag. Ang tawag ay gain. Nakakalito siya kasi both are measured by percentage. Pero first major difference ng fixed income type sa equity type, yung isa may pangako, yung isa wala. Hindi pareho siyang hindi sigurado, ha? Yung isa lang may pangako, yung isa wala. Yung fixed income, lower risks. Kaya low returns ang pinapangako. Sa equity type or buy type of investments, higher risks, that's why you are given the potential for higher returns. Oh, huwag kayo masisimbak doon sa salitang risk. Risk does not mean lugi ka kaagad. Risk, with reference to how we define investing, nabanggit na natin ito noon, commitment to use money, expecting, hoping, praying to make more money based on long-term goals. Lahat ng investment may risk. Lahat ng investment hindi sigurado. Ano kinalaman ng risk? Dahil umaasa ka lang sa investments, pag low risk, yung inaasahan mo na low returns, malamang mabigay sa'yo. Maliit na nga lang yung pinapaasa sa'yo eh. Malamang mabigay. Yung high risks na umaasa ka ng high returns, yung inaasahan mo na high returns, malamang hindi mabigay sa'yo. Maring mas mataas o mas mababa. Pwedeng wala. Wala kang return na makuha. Okay? Ulitin ko, both type of investments and all types of investments, walang siguradong investment. Yung isa may pangako, yung isa wala. Yung isang may pangako carries lower risks, merong risk pa rin. Yung walang pangako, higher risks. Pwedeng mas mataas nung sinasahan mo, pwedeng mas mababa. By the way, yung benefit, huwag niyong pagpapalitin na halimbawa mutual fund is a buy type of investment. Magkano bang interest ang kikitain ko sa mutual fund? Mali kaagad. Alam mo kaagad, mali ang appreciation ng isang tao kapag tinanong niya ilan ang interest ko sa stock market or ilan ang gain ko sa deposit ko. Ang deposit, interest. Okay? So, sa lend type of investment, fixed. Alam mo na magkano or kailan kababayaran or ibabalik yung pinahiram o ininvest mo na pera. Sa buy type of investment, hindi siya fixed. Hindi fixed yung gain. Hindi nga pwedeng ipangako. The mutual fund or equity type of investments, can only give you a historical performance or an educated forecast, pero cannot promise. They are not allowed to promise. Unlike sa fixed income or land type, as the term connotes, fixed income or fixed, alam mo na kung ilang interest ang kikitain mo, gano'ng katagal, and so on and so forth. Unlike yung sa buy type of investment, forecast, projection, depende sa'yo. Ang proseso, sa lend type of investment, you lend money or you invest money by way of lending it to the institution and be able to collect based on your agreed, fixed, guaranteed terms of engagement. Sa buy type of investment, as the term connotes, you need to buy sana at a lower price and sell it at a higher price. If that happens, you have a gain. If mas mababa ang selling price mo kumpara sa buying price mo, you have a loss. Clear, di ba? Simple lang. Follow? You follow?
Yes.
Okay. Ano yung mga available sa atin? Millennials, Filipino, dito sa Pilipinas, or even Filipinos abroad who would want to invest in the Philippines. Yung mga fixed income or land type of investment. Pag meron kang bank deposit, savings deposit, time deposit, checking account, nagpautang ka sa bangko. Kaya ka binibigyan ng
Interest.
Oh, pwede ka rin magpautang sa pamahalaan, tawag doon government securities or the big private corporations, companies. Diba? I was telling you about how I value utang because in pamahalaan, yung mga malalaking kumpanya, they also borrow money. Basta narinig yung salitang maturity period, alam mo na kung hanggang kailan. Maturity value, alam mo na kung magkano. Ang ginawa mo, lend type of investment. Yung buy type of investments, mga sample dyan, yung buying and selling of real property, nagba-buy and sell ka ng kotse, or you buy shares of stock in the stock market, or you buy cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. Mutual funds or UITFs, tawag dyan, pooled funds. Pooled, pinagsama-sama. Dito sa Pilipinas, common na example ng pooled funds are mutual funds and UITFs, Unit Investment Trust Fund. UITF is a bank product, not a bank deposit. Kaya maraming nalilito. Why? The same bank, the same teller, the same branch manager may have offered a savings deposit and also offered a UITF. Yung bank deposit may fixed or promised return. Yung UITF, wala. Kasi buy type of investment siya. Kahit anong negosyo is a buy type of investment. Miski na karinderya pa yan. Bumili ka ng mantika, bumili ka ng sahog, recado, bumili ka ng kubyertos, bumili ka ng plato. You hope to have a potahe na mabebenta mo, total ng benta mo mas mataas sana doon sa puhunan mo, kaya buy type of investment din ang kahit anong negosyo. Now, let's get into mutual funds. Sakto ako sa time ko, ha? Mutual funds is a buy type or equity type of investment. Okay? It's a form of collective investing. Collective, another term may be,
pooled,
what's your
funds.
Guess? Pooled. Yeah. Pooled funds. Okay? So, pooled funds like mutual funds and UITFs, these are funds from many, many retail investors, individuals or entities or companies that are aggregated, pinagsama-sama, put together for the purpose of investing or investment to make your money grow. The benefits or advantages of getting into pooled funds like mutual funds are the following. Economies of scale, meaning maliit na halaga, 5,000 pesos sa karamihan ng mutual funds to start a mutual fund investment, rough, 5,000 pesos. yung 5,000 pesos mo nakibakas doon sa ngayon 20-30 billion ng Phil Equity. Kung anong kitain ng 30-40 billion, yun yung kikitain ng 5,000 mo. Kaya economies of scale. Parang strength in numbers. Low capital, pero benefit of the volume of the big amount, yung total amount of the mutual fund. Diversification. Diba? Yung do not put all your eggs in one basket. Raf, I understand you invest directly in the stock market, right?
Yes, correct.
Or at least you have trade.
Correct.
To get into the stock market, it is foolish if you just buy one share of one stock or a share of one company. Mm-hmm. It is always advised that you buy different companies in different industries. That's called diversification. To have a good diversified portfolio.
Yeah.
Kailangan mo ng mga 200, 300,000, baka 1 million pa to have about 7 to 10 companies. 7 to 10 companies na meron kang ownership or meron kang shares of stock of 7 to 10 companies. Anywhere from 200, 500 to 1 million pesos. Para totoong diversified ang portfolio mo. Dito sa mutual fund, yung 5,000 mo, hindi na ikaw, investor, mutual fund investor, ang magsasabi kung anong bibili mong shares of stock. Kasi merong professional managers, experts, those who eat, sleep, drink, capital markets, sila ang magmamanage, sila ang magde-decide on a day-to-day basis. Next benefit, safety. Bakit pa safety? Safety, hindi ibig sabihin walang lugi. Safety, ibig sabihin, there is a government agency manning, regulating, guarding, guiding mutual funds, fund managers, and protecting the mutual fund investors. There is the SEC. Kaya, safe. Yung process pa nila, yung SOPs, protocols pa nila, contributes to the safety. On a day-to-day basis, imagine the fund manager reports it to the association of different fund managers of the mutual fund. Every day, that association will compute what will be the net asset value per share, NAVPS, NAVPS. What is NAVPS? That is the buying and selling price of any mutual fund. Ang nagbibigay ng buying and selling price, dinadaan pa doon sa association of different fund managers of different mutual funds. And daily, sinasabit din doon sa SEC. And then SEC will check, pass it back to the association, and then the association give it to the individual fund managers. So yung safetiness nitong getting into mutual fund, mataas ang aking kumpiyansa. Liquidity. Ano yung ibig sabihin ng liquidity? How easy or how fast you can turn into cash your investment. Lupa. Real estate. It's a good buy type of investment. Tumataas daw lagi ang presyo ng lupa. Pero liquidity, mababa siya. Bakit? Pagbebenta mo na yung condo mo, yung nakatiwangwang mong lupa, tumaas na presyo, maghahanap ka pa ng buyer. Kung susundan mo yung regular course of transactions, it will take what? From looking for a buyer, promoting your property, up to actual sale, nagpalitan ng pera, bayaran ng capital gains tax, lipatan ng titulo, 3 to 6 months para to liquidate your real estate property, lalo na kung yun ang klase ng investment mo. Sa mutual funds, anytime, pwede mong i-liquidate. Pwede mong gawing cash ulit yung investment mo. Ulitin ko, anytime. Ngayon, sasabihin na mga iba na may experience na, hindi yun, meron po silang holding period. Yes, meron silang holding period, pero pumasok ka bukas, Raf, Tuesday, ilabas mo Wednesday, pwede. Pero dahil nandun ka pa doon sa holding period, babawasan kanila ng exit fee. Pero kung kunwari, in a span of 3 months,